Cautiously optimistic is really a good way to put it.
A new drug in the fight against Alzheimer's disease.
We're still excited that more people will have the opportunity to have that extra time.
Amid that hope, a note of caution from Colorado doctors.
The benefits that a person in their family might notice are very minimal.
Tonight, we're taking an in-depth look at this controversial treatment and the pushback it's already facing.
The original plan was that Devin was going to shoot me after everyone else in that classroom.
Chilling testimony in the trial of one of the accused STEM school shooters.
The jury hearing new details directly from the other teen already serving a life sentence for the deadly attack.
And fast-moving danger. New warnings tonight after dozens of rescues at Colorado's rivers and creeks.
Many families across the nation struggling with an Alzheimer's diagnosis have fresh hope tonight, and it's all thanks to what's inside these tiny glass vials.
It goes by the brand name Aduhelm, and it's the first drug approved by the FDA in nearly two decades to treat Alzheimer's. The monthly treatment aims to slow the decline for people in the early stages of the illness.
But the drug is not without controversy. There are already questions about its effectiveness, as well as the price tag.
As CB Cotton reports, despite the concerns, this is very welcome news for one Colorado family.
We got married in 93.
Their fridge tells their life story.
This is me at the aquarium with our oldest grandson.
Each photo, a specific moment in time.
Take a look at this picture over here.
And Sam Van Wy knows the moments are starting to blur for his wife, Donna.
I've seen some digression, particularly this past year. This past 13 months have really been hard.
Donna is battling Alzheimer's. She too recognizes the changes in herself.
It's been up and down and up and down and up and down.
And Sam has witnessed it with other loved ones before.
It's depressing for me to see the changes with Donna, particularly after going through similar with my mom and then my brother.
His mother and brother both passed away from complications related to Alzheimer's. But Sam is optimistic that things can be different for Donna.
And that's what, you know, we have as our goal.
A new Alzheimer's drug from pharmaceutical company Biogen has he and his wife cautiously hopeful.
I hope that Donna will qualify. I think that would be wonderful.
The drug is aducanumab.
Dr. Victoria Pellick is a neurology and ophthalmology professor at CU's Alzheimer's and Cognition Center.
And it is a drug to remove the Alzheimer's proteins that abnormally build up in the brain, and then you develop Alzheimer's disease.
She says the Alzheimer's Association has put good context around expectations.
And cautiously optimistic is really a good way to put it, because we know this drug is not for everyone. It's only for a specific small population of patients who have mild symptoms.
And Pellick says some trials have shown the drug's effects may not be noticeable. One of the reasons the FDA's decision for the drug's accelerated approval has been met with controversy.
The decline is slower, and sometimes that's very hard to recognize on an individual basis.
But CU will be part of the drug's research going forward.
The CU Alzheimer's Center will be a participant in that phase 4 study.
If the drug's phase 4 research doesn't verify the drug's benefit, it could be removed from the market. For now, Sam and Donna are holding on to hope.
Regardless of whether or not Donna can qualify for it, we're still excited that more people will have the opportunity.
And to this moment in time.
You want to live.
I want to live.
With photojournalist Will Peterson, I'm CB Cotton, Denver 7.
And now let's dig a little deeper on how this drug works. In people with Alzheimer's, a protein called amyloid builds up on the cells of the brain, and that buildup disrupts how the brain cells function. This new treatment is designed to target and reduce levels of that harmful protein. The medication is given as a monthly infusion for patients with early stage Alzheimer's, and the goal is to slow cognitive decline and prevent their symptoms from becoming more severe.
Studies show the drug is effective at substantially reducing the amount of that protein, amyloid, in Alzheimer's patients. Critics say what's not clear is how strong the effect is on their symptoms. Now, for some perspective, trials ended in 2019 after failing to show enough evidence on the drug's effectiveness. A later review of the trials with additional data showed more promising results. Now, the FDA is giving the drug conditional approval. The Alzheimer's Association says that's the right move.
Individuals may have more time to actively participate in activities and to have sustained independence, hold on to their memories longer, experience their life longer. That includes relationships and time with family and friends. That's a game changer, and it brings new hope for all of our community.
Well, the FDA will require the drug maker to launch a new large-scale trial to measure the benefit of that treatment.
And for many Alzheimer's patients and their families, the next question is, what about the side effects?
The biggest risk of this drug is problems with swelling in the brain or even some small bleeding in the brain. One reassuring aspect is that when used carefully and when used with surveillance MRIs, brain scans to make sure that the side effects aren't happening, most people that do develop the side effects actually end up being okay.
And it will take several months for the drug to become available for most patients, and even then, it will likely be used on a case-by-case basis.
Another major concern here, the cost of care. Drug maker Biogen announced Monday the price for one treatment would be roughly $4,300. At one infusion each month, that quickly adds up to $56,000 per year. The Institute for Clinical and Economic Review released a report last month. It estimated the drug should cost between $2,500 and $8,300 per year. Biogen says cost assistance programs may help bring those out-of-pocket costs down to zero.
Today in the trial of accused STEM school shooter Devin Erickson, jurors got to hear from convicted shooter Alec McKinney. And McKinney answered questions about his conversations with Erickson. He described in detail what they planned in advance and how they pictured it would all go.
The plan was that Devin was going to essentially just unleash in that room. We both were. After everyone besides him and myself was dead in that classroom, he was going to then shoot me to make it look like he attempted to save everyone, and then ultimately he wanted to come off as the hero.
McKinney described how they both had connected with the story of Sol Pais. She's a Florida woman who was obsessed with the Columbine shootings. She was wanted for questioning by police after traveling to Colorado, buying a gun and making threats to schools in our state. She was found dead at the base of Mount Evans back in 2019. McKinney, by the way, is due back in court tomorrow morning for more questions.
Almost 1 year after Isabella Thallus was shot dead in Denver, her father and her boyfriend are filing a lawsuit against the accused shooter and the former police officer whose gun was used in that attack. Darian Simon, Isabella's boyfriend, was also injured in that shooting. Now, the lawsuit accuses former officer Daniel Politica of unsafely storing an AK-47 assault rifle. It claims he grew up with Michael Close and the two were friends. It accuses Politica of not reporting the weapon stolen until 10 to 12 days after Close shot and killed Isabella. His attorneys say the aim of the lawsuit is to seek answers and push for accountability.
In the middle of these 90-degree days, a dip in one of our rivers and creeks might sound pretty tempting. Of course, right now, that's maybe not a good idea in many places.
No, it really isn't. Denver 7's Andy Guajardo is catching up with crews dealing with dozens of rescues amid dangerous conditions.
Experts say June is one of the most dangerous times of the year for water activities, and that's because the snowmelt increases water levels. That's what we're seeing here at Clear Creek. And I want you to take a listen to that water rushing. That's more than 900 cubic feet per second. The water is flowing 10 times faster than it does during winter.
Hot. Yeah, it's hot.
As the weather heats up,
it's really hot,
and the snowpack melts, rivers and creeks are reaching high water levels, increasing water dangers.
The more water that's flowing, the faster it goes and the more power that it has. Just a little bit of water can actually knock you right off your feet.
Elias Holunga, a Golden Native, knows the dangers of Clear Creek all too well.
I've hit my head in there before and actually had people had to drag me out of the river.
Firefighters from across the U.S. spent the day training in Clear Creek for swift water rescues.
Rescues this time of year are extremely common. We had two rescues on Saturday, two children and then an adult as well that got off of their rafts and couldn't get out of the water.
On Monday, Poudre Fire Authority rescued five people from the Poudre River. They've performed at least 20 rescues since Memorial Day. To help keep people safe, access to Poudre River is now limited.
One of the best things to do is put your feet downstream, so that will help protect your head and you can see where you're going. Stay as calm as possible.
Officials also announced restrictions at Clear Creek due to dangerous conditions. Belly boats, inner tubes, and swimming will not be allowed. Kayaks, whitewater canoes, and stand-up paddle boards, to name a few, are exempt. If you plan to get in the water this weekend, experts recommend packing your life vest, a helmet, and a whistle in case you need to call for help.
These hazardous conditions can last anywhere from a few days to weeks. You can see that kayaker right there took a dip into the water. Luckily, he's got his safety vest on and a helmet. Now, if you spot someone in distress, experts say make sure you call 911 and make a mental note of the last place you saw that person. In Golden, Addy Guajardo, Denver 7.
A historic milestone today in our state. Senators voted to confirm the first Asian American Latina justice to the U.S. District Court in Colorado. Regina Rodriguez is the daughter of a Mexican American father and a Japanese American mother. On top of decades of her legal experience, Rodriguez was a founding member of the Latinas First Foundation.
Crunch time for the Avs back at Ball Arena and desperate to stop a two-game slide. Highlights from tonight's face-off against Las Vegas.
They don't always know right away that their vision's getting worse.
A spike in nearsightedness among kids. Why Colorado doctors say remote learning is having an effect.
If you think about a natural classroom setting, your children would be looking at the teacher far away.
We had the fourth straight day of 90s today. It looks like more sizzling weather is coming up.